Fury is a 2016 boss rush game, similar to that of Cuphead, I suppose. You play as this mysterious prisoner, fighting your way through countless jailers to escape this prison created to be unescapable. Not only is the premise of Fury incredibly intriguing, the gameplay also shines, even if it takes some time. There is a lot to enjoy with this game, so let's take a quick look at my thoughts on Fury. Before going in, I already had pretty high expectations for the game. I'd seen it all around the place as one of the games with the best boss designs, well, ever. And I'll admit, initially, I was kind of disappointed. I played for a bit and then gave the game up for a while. Just recently, I decided to give it another chance, and oh man, I am glad that I did. While not every boss was that incredible, the way they were designed was very innovative and unique. Plus, there were a few great bosses that especially stood out. But before that, let's quickly return to the story. The story, as you'd guess in a game like this, isn't very important. Yet, I still loved it because it was very interesting and deeper than it may have initially seemed. Everything is shrouded in mystery. You basically have no idea what's going on until the final boss. Yet, hints are spewed out all around, mainly from the very odd but nonetheless fascinating dialogue. The only part that slightly annoyed me was that some bosses were used as narrative devices. Now, you gotta take into account, this is a super short game with only about 10 bosses in total. So when almost a quarter of those don't pose a real challenge and instead are used for the story, it could be a little frustrating. Honestly, I didn't mind a whole ton except for one. Anyways, as I said, overall there's not that many bosses, yet that was completely fine. Each boss is incredibly diverse and unique. I can pretty much distinctly remember every single one and what they were like to fight. Luckily, this uniqueness wasn't brought about in a gimmicky way like other games seem to do. The variety always worked with the game mechanics. You see, the combat in Fury focuses on two main styles. There's just the normal stuff, which is where you can employ all of the prisoner's abilities. His sword, dodge, gun, parry. And then there's close quarter melee combat, which is utilized a lot less and mainly relies on quick parrying or dodging and then some counterattacking. Some bosses have a blend of both, others focus solely on one, or sometimes it changes up from stage to stage. Each boss is split up into stages, usually around 5 in total. Each stage serves as a sort of checkpoint as you get healed and if you die you can restart from there. But of course, it's still very easy to game over and restart from the very beginning. On paper, this concept seems way too easy, but in practice, the progression was honestly perfect. This is most likely why this game is praised so much for its boss design, as it really does show how amazing bosses can be. Fury is a very hard game, especially on the higher difficulties, yet no challenge ever felt unbeatable. I'd always start by absolutely sucking, losing on the first or second stages, but over time I'd slowly make it farther and farther, learning pattern after pattern, until I'd finally conquer the challenge. The stages of a boss usually did get progressively more challenging, but they always had certain elements from previous stages carry over, so they never felt completely unfair. All in all, a boss would usually take me about an hour to complete, which was a pretty perfect amount of time. As I mentioned, right at the beginning, the way this game controls can take a little getting used to. It felt significantly less smooth than I was expecting it to, but by the end I was completely okay with it. I still could never really get the hang of dodging though, I always thought it felt delayed or something. Ooh, another thing I really enjoyed was the combat animation. This stuff was so over the top and incredibly badass. It was my jam, especially the perfect parry animations. Alas, I cannot say the same for the actual cutscenes. The speaking was pretty wacky, but it wasn't game-changing or anything. And finally, oh man, does this game have a bopping soundtrack. It's one of those indie games that uses music from all sorts of different producers, yet it all blended together and fit every moment very well. So, as a whole, Fury is a game I probably won't find myself returning to all that much or anything, but it was for sure a wonderful experience, so I'll give it a B+. Thank you guys for watching, please like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and if you can, make sure to check out Fury. Thanks again, bye.